A few basic bolt-on modifications can take the LML over 500 wheel horsepower and to about 1,000 wheel torque. Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here. Today we are continuing on with our Duramax performance upgrade series. Today we're talking about the Duramax LML. A few basic bolt-on modifications can take the LML over 500 wheel horsepower and to about 1,000 wheel torque. However, there are a couple weak points with this engine that we need to go ahead and address first. So in this video, we're gonna go ahead and cover engine power limits. We're gonna talk about some supporting modifications to address some of the weak points on these engines, and then we'll go ahead and jump into our best bolt-on modifications. So let's go ahead and jump into power limits of the Duramax LML. The first weak point or power limitation that you're going to get to, as is true with just about any Duramax, is going to be the transmission. The Allison 1000 transmissions on these engines can handle about 450 wheel horsepower somewhat reliably when used with transmission tuning. You can get up to around 500 out of the stock transmission. However, at that point, you're definitely going to be sacrificing reliability. So really anything above 450 wheel horsepower, you're definitely going to want transmission tuning, but you're also going to want to start looking into some upgrades to increase the power capacity of the transmission. The second weak point, and one of the things that we discussed in our problems and reliability video that we did with the LML, was the LML switch to the CP4.2 injection pump from the CP3. This was really a downgrade from a performance standpoint because the CP4.2 flows 20% less than the CP3. And the CP4.2 is known to basically self-destruct, which can lead to some very expensive repairs. The second thing is supporting the CP4.2. As is true with any Duramax, you're definitely gonna wanna add a lift pump, and I'd recommend adding a lift pump before you make any of these performance modifications that we're gonna talk about here, and especially before you add any form of tuning to your LML. The main thing here is helping support the CP4.2, just since it doesn't flow quite as much as a CP3, a lift pump will help take some stress off of it, which is really going to go a long ways with respect to reliability of the CP4.2 and preventing that from self-destructing. Once you've got a lift pump on here, the CP4.2 is going to be good to around the 600 wheel horsepower range. At that point, you're going to need to look at doing a CP3 swap or looking into more advanced fueling modifications. The injectors are actually pretty strong on these vehicles. They can handle close to the 600 horsepower mark. However, we would recommend upgrading your injectors when you do upgrade the turbocharger, which then brings us to the turbocharger limitation. The factory turbocharger is gonna tap out about 525 wheel horsepower. You can probably get a few extra out of that if you put it on a max effort kill tune, but 525 is really gonna be your maximum semi-reliable range. And really anything above 500 wheel horsepower, it's gonna be smart to start thinking about just a bolt-in turbo upgrade if you're looking to reliably make somewhere in the 500 plus wheel horsepower range. And then the last thing here is the pistons. The pistons are known to crack around 650 wheel horsepower. So if you're really looking at pushing anywhere beyond 600 or 650, you're gonna wanna start looking at internal upgrades. The two weak points on these engines are gonna be the transmission as well as the CP4.2. To address these weak points, the two things that you're gonna wanna do is first of all, add a lift pump, and do this before you add any additional modifications to the LML. And then the second thing is going to be transmission tuning. Whether you're just running a basic tune and running 400 wheel horsepower, or you're really trying to push the limits here, I recommend transmission tuning. It'll help ensure longevity and reliability out of the transmission, and it'll help you be able to push some of these higher power levels reliably. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump into our modifications here. The first one is going to be engine tuning as well as transmission tuning. Engine tuning is really where you're getting all of your big power gains out of. It's going to allow you to run higher boost levels from your turbocharger, which therefore is going to be where all of the power gains come from. The best options here are going for EFI Live or HP tuners, and the reason being is that those can support transmission tuning. I would recommend transmission tuning early on. It's certainly going to be helpful. Even if you're running some of the lower power levels, it will help you be able to get closer to that 450 wheel horsepower range reliably without needing upgrades out of the transmission. Tuning alone can really get you to some of the power limits of the transmission and the engine here. However, all of the other modifications modifications on this list are really going to be things that are going to help support tuning. Tuning is really the building block of performance modifications, and then everything that we do after it is to help increase engine efficiency and add reliability when tuned. Now, as a quick alternative option here, if you're really only looking to add tuning to get some small horsepower benefits, to get better towing, and to get some better fuel economy, you can stick with something like the PPE Accelerator Tuner, which is just a plug-and-play tuner. It's about $450. It doesn't support transmission tuning, but if you are just looking to run the very low power levels and get some of the other benefits out of tuning, like better efficiency and increased miles per gallon, then something like the PPE Accelerator is going to be about half the cost of getting engine tuning and transmission tuning with HP tuners or EFI Live. So now jumping into the second modification on our list, that's going to be a cold air intake. A lot of people will say a cold air intake isn't really necessary at some of these power levels that we're talking about. But as I mentioned with tuning, it's all about increasing efficiency and reliability when tuned. Tuning increases boost that your turbocharger is pushing. And so at this point, it's a really good idea to start bringing more airflow and increased air density to the turbocharger, which is going to help take some stress off of the turbocharger. It's going to increase turbo spool, give you faster throttle response, and you're also going to see some maybe 1 to 2 mile per gallon fuel economy benefits. An intake is worth it because you're going to get some fuel economy savings. You're also going to increase the reliability of the turbocharger and take some stress off of it by bringing more air to it. While the factory intake system is strong enough to be able to handle some of these power levels we're talking about, there certainly is zero downsides to adding an upgraded intake. Once we're tuned and running more boost from the turbocharger and have a cold air intake bringing more air in, it's important to now look at the exhaust components and get more air out of the engine quickly. What happens when you're running more boost and creating more exhaust gases is you then get a buildup of back pressure within the exhaust system. This back pressure works as a force against the turbocharger, so it slows down turbo spool, it puts additional stress on the turbocharger, and also leads to higher EGTs. So we're going to go ahead and want to look at exhaust upgrades to help lower EGTs and reduce that back pressure within the exhaust system, which is then going to add some reliability to the turbocharger and help it spool more quickly and operate more efficiently. Now, since the LML does have a DPF and SCR and all the emissions equipment that you can imagine, we're going to talk about exhaust upgrades in two different components. The first one is going to be the downpipe, which is what this is right here. Downpipe's the first portion of the exhaust system. It bolts up directly to the turbocharger. And then we're going to go ahead and talk about DPF back, or what I'll call cat back exhaust systems. The most important exhaust upgrade is going to be the downpipe. The downpipe bolts up directly to the turbocharger. It's going to have the greatest reduction on back pressure and exhaust gas temperatures. This is where you're going to see the biggest performance gains, the biggest power gains, and the biggest EGT reduction. Here we have our boosted performance 3-inch downpipe. It's made of 304 stainless steel, which is the highest quality material that you can get for exhaust components. And it's got a nice heat shield on it as well. It's a full 3-inch system that's completely clean throughout. It removes a lot of the restriction that the factory downpipe has because the factory downpipe is crushed in certain locations. When it comes to exhaust upgrades, a downpipe is absolutely the best portion of the exhaust system to upgrade, where you're going to see the biggest benefits. If you want to take things a little bit further, reduce some more back pressure, lower EGTs a little bit more, then getting a cat back part of the exhaust system is worth it as well. You're not quite going to see that much from a power gain perspective. You're probably only going to notice a couple horsepower from it. You will get some lower EGTs. It is worth it since you can get some cat-back systems relatively cheap. It's not absolutely necessary. A downpipe is going to be where your biggest gains are going to come from. The last modification that we're going to talk about is an upgraded intercooler. An intercooler definitely isn't necessary, especially even at 500 wheel horsepower, but it probably is one of the best reliability modifications that you could do to the LML, especially if you tow heavily frequently. An intercooler isn't really going to add power, but what it's going to do is give you more consistent power. It's going to help you keep your intake air temperatures down by cooling the air more efficiently before it enters the engine. So we're going to have colder air entering the engine more consistently, which is going to help lower engine temps. It's going to help lower exhaust gas temperatures, and overall it's going to give you more more consistent power while also giving you tons of reliability benefits and overall just improving the health of the engine. An intercooler is about a $1,500 upgrade if you get it with the intercooler piping. So it is the most expensive thing on this list. And because of that, it's not absolutely required if you're looking at pushing moderate power levels or if you don't do a ton of towing. But if you are looking to maximize engine efficiency and maximize reliability and engine longevity when tuned, then an intercooler is going to be a fantastic upgrade for those purposes. So that covers it for our bolt-on modifications for the LML. There's a couple other things to mention here. If you are really looking to maximize engine efficiency and reduce the most airflow restriction that you can, there are a couple other worthwhile upgrades, those being an upgraded Y-bridge, up pipes, and intercooler piping if you don't opt for a full intercooler package. These things certainly aren't required at these power levels. However, they are good upgrades to help reduce some restrictions, improve efficiency, and overall really maximize airflow and efficiency within the LML. So if you're looking to build the most efficient, most reliable LML possible, then these are good upgrades to look at as well. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our video on bolt-on modifications for the LML. We will do a series down the road talking about some of these more advanced upgrades like turbocharger upgrades. So if you appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for our future LML upgrade videos.